Away yan, running, dwelting at the start because of a stumble was the seven thirsty boots. So the favorite outwell, that is Glossomer. Up the inside in second is Selling the Drama, and Waiting for Pleasure came away in that third place position. Goodbye Carolina probes up the inside to be in fourth position, and Lost Lake is trying to save some ground, but the rail is protected by Downtown Katie. Hum of the Funk has one beaten, and a lackluster beginning leaves Thirsty Boots last of all with 3/4 of a mile to go. So as they leave the first turn, it's Glossomer at 3-5, making every pole a winning one at this point, and shows the way by three. Selling the Drama is relegated to second, and Winning for Pleasure is off the fence in spot number three. Downtown Katie trying to squeeze on through the fence, and Goodbye Caroline is in fifth position, midpoint of the backstretch run. Lost Lake still in front of a couple, which includes the back markers of Hum and the Funk, and nothing yet from Thirsty Boots. So Glossomer has been left unopposed and dictates her own terms, leads the way by almost three. Downtown Katie now grabs second, and Selling the Drama gets a couple of niggles to stay at the speed, and Goodbye Carolina starting to hit her best stride up the rail. Midpoint of the far turn run, and it's Glossomer playing Catch Me If You Can, but Downtown Katie has upset on her mind as they turn for home. Glossomer hugs that corner like a train on tracks and shot away by a length and a half. Downtown Katie is running a big race, and here she comes with giant strides on the yielding ground at 9-2. Still leading is Glossomer. Downtown Katie continues to chip away. Glossomer holding. Glossomer getting there. Glossomer by a neck. Beating Downtown Katie, Goodbye Carolina, and Hummin' the Funk. Glossomer with winning jockey J.D. Acosta. William Gottwals is the winning owner, trained by Lynn Ashby. The winner was bred in Maryland by the owner. Time of the race was 137.65 seconds. Pace $3 exacta, $12. $2 trifecta, $22.60. The $1 superfecta, $41.40. The double worth $12 for a $2 ticket, and the dollar pick three, $17.90. Race four is next. No changes. 23 minutes until post time. All set. Away and running. Dwelting at the start because of a stumble was the seven Thirsty Boots. So the favorite outwell, that is Glossomer. Up the inside in second is Selling the Drama, and Waiting for Pleasure came away in that third place position. Goodbye Carolina probes up the inside to be in fourth position, and Lost Lake is trying to save some ground, but the rail is protected by Downtown Katie. Hum of the Funk has one beaten, and a lackluster beginning leaves Thirsty Boots last of all with 3/4 of a mile to go. So as they leave the first turn, it's Glossomer at 3-5, making every pole a winning one at this point, and shows the way by three. Selling the Drama is relegated to second, and Winning for Pleasure is off the fence in spot number three. Downtown Katie trying to squeeze on through the fence, and Goodbye Caroline is in fifth position, midpoint of the backstretch run. Lost Lake still in front of a couple, which includes the back markers of Hum and the Funk, and nothing yet from Thirsty Boots. So Glossomer has been left unopposed and dictates her own terms, leads the way by almost three. Downtown Katie now grabs second, and Selling the Drama gets a couple of niggles to stay at the speed, and Goodbye Carolina starting to hit her best stride up the rail. Midpoint of the far turn run, and it's Glossomer playing Catch Me If You Can, but Downtown Katie has upset on her mind as they turn for home. Glossomer hugs that corner like a train on tracks and shot away by a length and a half. Downtown Katie is running a big race, and here she comes with giant strides on the yielding ground at 9-2. Still leading is Glossomer. Downtown Katie continues to chip away. Glossomer holding. Glossomer getting there. Glossomer by a neck. Beating Downtown Katie, Goodbye Carolina, and Hummin' the Funk.